Criminal charges are filed against Philippine lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. over a four-year-old murder case. The Negros Oriental congressman is also being linked to the assassination of the province's governor, Roel Degamo. But he has insisted the Teves clan had nothing to gain from the weekend attack. Jose Carretero reports.
A Philippine lawmaker who denied that his clan may have been behind the death of their political rival, Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo, was suddenly charged with murder for a separate killing that happened in 2019. The CIDJ filed charges against Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnolfo Teves with the DOJ. Teves and five others are accused in the murder of Negros Oriental board member Miguel Dungog. Teves on Monday issued a Facebook video statement where he insisted that his clan had nothing to gain with the assassination of Governor Degamo over the weekend. The congressman's brother, Henry Teves, was unseated by the Election Commission and replaced with Degamo in September 2022. Meanwhile, police investigators are a step closer to possibly identifying who ordered the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Pajardo says suspects in the killing have provided material information that could help unmask the mastermind. Pajardo declined to reveal who among the suspects gave the information. She, however, assured the families of the suspect they will be given equal protection.
On the part of the SITG po ay tuloy-tuloy po yung ginagawa nating investigation, and in fact, nag-iingat nga po tayo sa pagbibigay po ng mga detalye dahil ongoing pa po yung post-out operations po natin laban po doon sa mga hindi pa po na-account na mga suspect at ilan ba pong mga jandos.
Pajardo also says the four suspects have been transferred to the PNP Custodial Center in Camp Crame to ensure their safety. Based on the ballistic exam, some recovered firearms from the suspects have matched pieces of evidence recovered by the task force.
May nagmatch doon sa mga bala at doon sa nakuha or na-discover, na-uncover na mga assault rifles. So this is very important for us. No? We have SOCO here, part of the SITG or the Special Investigation Task Group, to make sure that all evidence, pieces of evidence will be examined.
The PNP leadership has also relieved the whole Bayawan City Police Force on Tuesday. They will be replaced by personnel from the Negros Oriental Police Provincial Office. For the governor's widow, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, their family welcomes the huge outpouring of support as they continue to seek justice. Some senators, led by Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, pay their respect to Governor Degamo. Zubiri calls the brazen act political terrorism.
Kinundin na po namin in the strongest sense itong ginawang political terrorism. This is a terrorist act that was brought upon this province.
Jose Carretero, ABS-CBN News.
Leaders of the Tau Gamma Phi fraternity based in Adamson University receive a severe dressing down from Philippine senators during a hearing on the alleged hazing death of their member, John Matthew Salilig. The details from Sherian Torres.
Roy De La Cruz, a Tau Gamma recruit, recounts the welcoming and initiation rites he experienced during the hearing of the Senate Justice Committee on the alleged hazing case of Adamson student John Matthew Salilig. The hearing held by Senate Committees on Justice and Human Rights and Public Order and Dangerous Drugs was prompted by the privileged speech of Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri on Wednesday. Seven suspects in the Salilig's hazing case are also present at the Senate. De La Cruz says the initiation rites were done in an unfinished house in a village in Cavite where he, Salilig, and a certain Lee were hazed.
Nung during initiation po, naka-blindfold po ako nung first. Pero tinanong po nila ako if gusto ko pong tanggalin. So sabi ko, sige po, para di ako mahilo masyado. Napalo po. Siguro po, opo, pare-parehas lang po. During initiation po, parang umano na po si Matt na medyo masakit daw po dyan niya kasi po yata nag-LBM siya that day. Pero tumali pa rin po.
De La Cruz says frat leaders later transferred them to a house in Parañaque City. At this time, De La Cruz says Salilig appeared weak. He adds the leaders refused to let him go after Lee was picked up by a relative. The hunt continues for 10 other Tau Gamma members, four of whom were identified as alias Tags, Bones, Ralph, and Scotty. Police says 22 individuals are involved in Salilig's death.
18 are suspects in the anti-correspondence. Six were inquested, one surrendered, kaya in-inquest na rin. One of the 10 as reported to Binyan Police Station by the father have accordingly died.
The suspects turned down the committee's repeated offer to be assisted by a counsel as senators questioned them.
Hindi ka makagraduate. Hindi ka makakuha ng board.
Opo.
Diretso ka sa Muntinlupa.
Yes po, sir.
Alam na mga magulang mo yan. Sinayang mo na yung kinabukasan mo. Ganon din yung mga ibang nandito.
Bakit kinakailangan yung paluan, yung hazing, or what other forms? Bakit kinakailangan yan sa isang fraternity?
Yung sa amin, sa akin po kasi ano, sumusunod lang po ako dun sa tradition po nung mga inano. Kaya pag ano po, natatakot po ako na hindi sumunod kasi baka po yung DA po ako.
Adamson University officials also received a mouthful from senators. Senator Tulfo is eyeing to amend the Anti-Hazing Act and inject provisions that will slap life imprisonment to fraternity recruiters, hosts of initiation rites, and leaders of fraternity chapters whose activities will result in the death of recruits. The senator is also looking at including school administrators in the charges should they fail to stop illegal fraternities inside their campus. Sharian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
A man seeks forgiveness for his son, who was among the persons of interest in the death of John Matthew Salili. He told investigators his son actually tried to help save the college student from the fatal injuries he sustained in their fraternity ceremony. This exclusive report from Nico Bawa.
Four persons of interest surrendered to the NBI Death Investigation Division Monday afternoon in the investigation of John Matthew Salilig's death. One of them was accompanied by his father, Nards. He says he only discovered his son's membership in Tau Gamma Phi fraternity after he asked for help and admitted that Matthew was missing since his initiation. His son initially said that he only had drinks with friends.
Sobrang parang gumagsak sa akin ng langit at lupa dahil hindi ko naman inaasahan na kasali siya sa ganyan dahil lang alam ko kung mapasok siya, nag-aakal siya at sumusulit siya sa mga laging pangaral ko na huwag kang magpagkada, lalong-lalo na yung prat, iwasan mo yan.
Nards and his son were one of the first to report to the NBI and helped in the search for Matthew before his body was found in Cavite.
Sa pamilya ni Matt, humihingi po ako sa inyo ng deepest condolence sa inyo at humihingi po ako ng tawad sa inyo sa mga nangyari. Pero hindi po sangkot ang anak ko sa paglibing sa kanya, sa tapon ng kanyang bangkay.
His son narrated that he tried to administer CPR on Matthew when he lost consciousness. He also told fraternity officers that Matthew needed a doctor.
Isa po siya sa talagang nagpilit na revive ang anak niyo. Dalhin sa ospital, gawa ng paraan para mabuhay. Nag-volunteer siya na alagaan na para mabuhay pa ang anak niyo. Pero as a member, siguro hindi naman siya masusunod.
While Nards is torn about the situation, he is hoping that this will teach his son a lesson.
Siguro talagang kaloob ng Panginoon Diyos na mangyari siya para matauhan siya at aral na sa kanya kung sakasaling mapatunayan naman na talagang wala naman siyang pagkakasala sa nangyari. Dahil ang pagkakasama, mali lang niya, member siya.
Their family is anxious on how they're going to cover the legal expenses since he is already retired.
Nakahanda po kami na dahil sa totoo lang po, sa ngayon po wala naman po akong trabaho. Asawa ko naman po ganun din. Asa po sa anak ko wala, empleyado lang din po.
The authorities, meanwhile, are still looking for the remaining other fraternity members who were involved in the hazing.
The persons of interest will remain under the custody of the NBI. It's still not clear if any of them might become a witness until the NBI has studied all of their statements. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.